Now remember that we said that the voltage at the input is not equal to the voltage at the generator. Right here. This input voltage does not equal VG, but we need to be able to find what it is. So let's draw our transmission line with its ZL. It has a characteristic impedance of Z0 and a length of L. Just as before, this is Z equals 0 and this is Z equals minus L. If I wanted to find Vn, I could find it exactly the way we did before. Let's write that equation. That's going to be V0 plus e to the minus j beta z, but remember we substituted in minus L, so it ends up being e to the plus j beta L, plus gamma times V0 plus e to the minus j beta L. So that is one form, one way that we could write Vn, that is V at minus L. But there's another one here. Again, look at this just from the point of view of circuits. Plus minus VG. If I said that I had Zn here, remember that's the input impedance that I just calculated, and that I had RG here, the voltage across Zn is Vn. That ought to look just like a voltage divider to you. You've done this before. So if you had this voltage VG that was being split across two resistors, RG and Zn, you would know what the voltage just across the Zn is, Vn, from voltage dividers. Vn is going to be Vg times Zn over Zn plus Rg. That's just using a voltage divider. But look, this voltage is the same as the one that's up here. So these two voltages are equal, and we can use this to solve for a very important factor, and that is V0 plus. So far, we've just used V0 plus in our equation, but we really don't know what it is. And in fact, there's no way for us to just look at the picture and determine what V0 is. We have to use this equation right here. So let's solve for that. V0 plus, which is all on the left-hand side, is going to be VG Zn over Zn plus Rg divided by e to the j beta L plus gamma e to the minus j beta L. So there's an equation for V0. It gives us a value in volts. We know the input impedance because that was just a function of the load, the characteristic impedance of the line, and the length of the line. So we know Zn. We assume that we know Vg and Rg because those are a generator that we chose or that we defined. The reflection coefficient is a function of ZL and Z0, so we can find that. Beta is a function of the wavelength or a function of the frequency, so we can find that. So all of the parameters on the right-hand side are typically values that we can find, and they allow us to calculate V0 plus.